easily one of the most controversial and intellectually stimulating books of the early 2000s, Shantaram by Gregory David Roberts is a 934-page book that's soon to become an Apple TV Plus series. The book is a semi-autobiographical novel that looks at the journey of one man, Lindsay, as he escapes into the chaotic city of Mumbai, India, and finds himself embroiled in drugs, mafia schemes, and so much more. Incidentally, Shantaram was supposed to be turned into a film years ago. Johnny Depp had acquired the rights of the book, and the Queen of Katwe director Meera Nair was to helm the project. While that didn't work out for reasons unknown, the book will now be made into a 10-episode show for Apple TV Plus, which stars Charlie Hunnam and will be directed by Justin Kurzel. Kurzel is best known for the 2015 Michael Fassbender star Macbeth. The book Shantaram tells the story of a mysterious man called Lin, and Gregory David Roberts is just as mysterious a figure. But what was his personal life really like, and how close is it to the book? Let's find out. Early life. Gregory David Roberts was born Gregory John Peter Smith in 1952 in Melbourne, Australia. While there isn't much known about his childhood, he was known to be an extremely rebellious teen who quit school at 18 to marry a girl. He worked a day job in a factory and went to night school to continue his education. He managed to pursue a degree in philosophy at Melbourne University. In interviews, he claims that his degree helped him greatly as a writer, which explains the allegorical references in Shantaram. Divorce, drugs, and robberies. Roberts was involved in a number of anarchist causes as a college student between 1969 and 1975. But in 1976, his life took a dark turn when his wife divorced him and took full custody of their 5-year-old daughter. He said he fell apart at this time and his depression drove him to heroin, and he carried out petty thefts and robberies to support his drug use. He was called the Gentleman Bandit because he wore a 3-piece suit, used a fake plastic gun, and said good morning or good evening to his victims before robbing them. The Great Escape. Gregory David Roberts was captured and sentenced to 19 years in prison in 1978. He managed to escape in 1980 and became the most wanted man in Australia. A biker group and some revolutionaries helped him escape to New Zealand, where he got involved in the conservation campaign to save a sacred Maori mountain in 1981. He was captured twice and escaped both times, and then ran away to India under the assumed name Lindsay with a fake New Zealand passport. From Lin to Shantaram. For the first 6 months, he hid in a remote village in Maharashtra. It's in that village that he was given the name Shantaram, a man of God's peace. He then moved to Mumbai, then called Bombay, where he lived in the slums and started a medical clinic. He was soon embroiled with a mafia boss who became his mentor, for whom he counterfeited currency and passports, played a street soldier, and smuggled gold. The big idea. He was caught and sent to prison and spent a 3-month-long sentence in Mumbai's Arthur Road Jail. In a 2004 interview, he revealed that when he was being flogged using a bamboo cane and he thought he died there in a pool of his own blood, a voice clearly spoke in my head and said, "This is damn good material." All around the world. He made his way across Europe and Asia as part of smuggling operations, and he was also working with the Mujahideen in Afghanistan during the Soviet invasion. He also starred in Bollywood movies as an extra, managed to start a casting and a travel agency, and even played in a rock act in Germany. All of this lasted until he was captured in Frankfurt in 1990 and extradited to Australia. Jail time and writing Shantaram. From 1991 to 1997, Gregory David Roberts spent 6 years in prison, out of which 2 were in solitary confinement. He started writing Shantaram in solitary, but the prison guard destroyed his manuscript twice, and both times he had finished over 300 pages. And finally, in 2002, he completed the book and sold the manuscript to publishers in the US, the UK, and Australia. By 2003, he was a household name. Since then, Gregory David Roberts has only written one book called The Mountain Shadow, which was a sequel to Shantaram. He had a plan to write 4 books, but now he's 67 years old, and The Mountain Shadow took him 11 years to write. But what a roller coaster of a life he's had. Let's hope Apple TV Plus can do full justice to his life and the book that was inspired by it. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, be sure to check out all our other content and don't forget to subscribe.